Roger Craig Smith, and you lucky person, are listening to Brigade Radio 1.
Responsibility can be a burden, you know. Don't let it shackle who you are.
I am Soggy, the man who will end your life. Now die, Flynn Shifo!
B.O.W., that scumbag Irving left behind to set us up.
Ghostly gunslinger leads to gold. Source and date, Dallas Morning Herald, 7th of April, 1985. Prospector Cy Burris of Albuquerque had another fruitless day searching for gold in southeastern New Mexico. But as the 60-year-old former rodeo rider set off for home, he spotted a young man far off in the distance down the ravine where he was headed. Hoping for a bit of company, Cy hurried along to catch up with him. And when he did, he decided that his new companion was not very friendly, said Cy. He had sandy yellow hair, a gun belt, and an insolent sneer. I turned to leave, but he challenged me. He said, "What's your hurry? You're a prospector looking for gold, right? Go up that rise. There'll be a valley ahead on your right. Go down to it, and when you see an old axe handle stuck in a tree, dig beneath its trunk." Then the stranger turned and walked away. Surprised, I shouted after him to ask who he was. He looked at me, hard, and said, "Friend, call me William Bonney. You know me as Billy the Kid." I figured he must have been drunk or joking. Nevertheless, Cy hurried off and to his amazement, found the tree with an axe handle. He dug down and found his gold. It was in the rotted remains of a Wells Fargo money bag. There were old gold and silver coins, minted in the 1870s and 1890s. Historians now believe the coins may be part of the loot Billy the Kid stole during his outlaw career. The $10,000 worth of booty almost matches exactly the description of one of his holdups of a Wells Fargo stagecoach.
You better subscribe to this channel before you look uncool.